Jesus. Yo, ndiyalunywa. Ngicela untolikele tata. You know, I'm sitting down there. I'm standing up. I'm excited and I'm thinking. I'm just looking back at where from the time we started.
Ndikhangela emva apho saqala khona.
And I just remembered and the Lord began to play a history yale nkonzo.
Inkonzo yandibonisa imbali yelibandla.
Oh my goodness. Bazalwana kusetyenziwe.
Brethren, we have worked hard.
People have worked.
Abantu basebenzile.
People have toiled.
Abantu baye basebenza nzima.
People have labored.
Abantu basebenze nzima.
I think at this time,
ndiyacinga ngelixesha,
what blesses me the most,
eyona nto indisikelela kakhulu,
is to see,
ukubona,
that bakhona abalandeli,
ukuba there are followers, there is a remnant.
Uthuba waxa ithetha no David,
when the Lord speaks to David,
asoze ndikushiye wedwa,
says I will not leave you,
and asoze I will make sure, that is, there is a remnant in the house of David,
ukuba ikhona intsalela endlini ka,
I will make sure that ukhona umlandeli,
that there is a remnant
endlini ka David,
in the house of David.
UDavid ke,
now David,
siyamazi ba ngukhokho wokhokho wokhokho.
We know that he is the great great grandfather
of Jesus Christ.
Ka Jesu Christ.
This was a prophetic moment.
Yayilixesha ke li okanye lixesha eli lesiprofeti.
Where God was endorsing.
Aputhixo wayebonakalisa.
The future purpose.
Injongo yekamva.
Or the purpose that was to come.
Ikamva elalisaya kubawo.
Or a manifestation.
Okanye imbonakaliso.
Of his will.
Yenjongo yakhe.
And I'm sitting here looking back and I'm saying, Lord, the enemy came and tried. The enemy came and attacked. And the enemy came and sought to destroy. That's the reality that we have gone through. A season of testing as this church. We have gone through a season
of being tested
as this church. As Isaiah 66, rather Psalm 66 would say, that we have been tested, that we have been tried, and the Lord allowed situations. The Lord allowed circumstances. The Lord allowed people to stand on our heads.
This is his word, that he allowed these things.
As Ecclesiastes chapter 3 speaks to us about times and season, my prophet. There's a time to cry. There's a time to weep. And there's a time for joy. There's a time to plant. And there is a time to reap. There is a time to celebrate. There's a time to give birth. And there's a time for loss. There is a time to be barren. You see, when
we
are in a time of barrenness, my young people, when we are in a time of barrenness and the Lord has silenced everything in your life, when God closes your womb and your spiritual womb, whether we are man or a woman, there is a reason why God has closed your womb. When everything is silent, when everything is quiet, it is a great opportunity for you to be calm, to be still, to listen. But more often than not, at a time of barrenness, because
usibeleko. Because your womb
sidalelwe ukuzala.
Is meant to give birth.
We begin to panic.
See,
we get depressed.
Sibe depressed.
We have anxiety.
Sibe anxiety.
Ngoba ikhona into engenzekiyo.
Because there's something that's not happening that is supposed to happen.
Now, Psalm 46,
God says in the book of Psalm 46,
be still and know that I am God. I will take care of you in all seasons, in all circumstances, in all situations. And when I had my 7 years of muteness, just like Elizabeth's husband, I would feel inadequate.
That is Ziva. That is Ziva.
Yes. That is Ziva. I was like broken.
I felt
there was something missing. And at that time, I had so many anxiety attacks. At the same time, at that time, I was going through a journey of infirmity.
In other times,
it's not only the enemy that attacks. The Lord sends or opens a door for the demonic realm to do whatever they want to do with you. Just like in the time of Job. What are
you saying,
Pastor? In essence, if you are here today and you feel inadequate, You feel less important. You feel unproductive and inappropriate. Wait on the Lord. For the time of celebration is coming. One of the things that the Lord told me when I was in a time of silence, the Lord said, I am purifying you. I am purging you. This fiery furnace, ipinda pindiwe. One thing after another. It never rains but pours.
A white man would say, I net in Jekodwa.
Is a better matter. Kuti pangapa. Utusamamelele. Kuti pangapa. Utusamamelele. Benga to better live good and strong.
There's another one that comes after.
There were times where I would literally faint. In closing, before I just appreciate the fathers, the second last time of a near-death experience that happened just before COVID, I was going out of bed in the morning, going to the bathroom. As I stood up, my knees gave way.
Amadolo ayekelela.
I was wobbling.
Ndangathi ndiya shukushuku.
And my head was spinning.
Inhloko yangathi iyazungeza iyajikelela.
Out of the blue. Say out of the blue.
Yes, akuphe.
Because kukhona situations.
Because there are situations
that are sudden.
Ezifika ngesaquphe.
They shock you.
Ziyakuthusa.
They shake you. They minimize you. And you are sure that you're dying. I crawled in desperation.
I was lifted by my son Unako.
We jumped into the car, Nomayoyo. My husband drove through Cape Road with hazards. And a hooter.
hazards.
As we entered A&E.
Asingene A&E.
Emergency and accident and emergency situation.
Kwela gumbi ke lengozi.
A Greenacres Hospital.
Abe Greenacres Hospital.
I vomited.
The palace.
Out of the blue. I almost lost my sight. The last time I saw people, they were blurry. Everyone was around me. Drips. And I heard from a distance someone saying, "Iswekile, iswekile, iswekile."
Diabetes.
And at that time, right at that time, my tongue was going back and touching my cleft palate. And the moment of death had come. And I want to say to us,
do not be afraid, do not fear.
Doyana yo, tinga pigi, iti isa e vagua.
I will film Susu akungega fiki.
You will never die before your time. You will not die before your time.
And I want to say to people who have lost things, if you have lost someone, if you have lost your business, if you have lost your child, be it to drugs or anything,
when your day has not come,
you will not die.
If your day has not come, awuzukufa.
It's time for resurrection.
What I saw here this morning
says to us,
it's
celebration time. It's resurrection time. Let them judge you. Let them say things about you. Iba ngumluwenyama. Umluwenyama ila braai itu ibekwe pa spit braai.
God does sometimes
allow
things
anga keko
as though he is absent,
kanti ukho,
yet he is ever present.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Can we give Jesus a big hand of praise?
Hallelujah.
There's a portion of Genesis chapter 12, but I'm just going to read
Genesis.
This one verse, as we appreciate our fathers
with all humility, can all the fathers please stand?
Please don't be ashamed. If you have a child out of wedlock, it doesn't matter the circumstance at this time.
But at the end, you are a father. Now the Lord says to us today,
our fathers, my strong men, pillars of our homes, preservers of legacies, protectors of our children. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I will make your name great. I will turn you into a great nation. I will bless you. I will make your name great. And you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you. And whoever curses you, I will curse. Whoever curses you, I will curse. And all the peoples on earth will be blessed through you. And so at this time, the Bible says, Abraham left as the Lord had told him. And Lot went with him. As we appreciate you today, After being blessed by the Lord, I noticed something in this portion of scripture. That obedience came.
God taking him out of his home country from the soil of his forefathers.
The soil that bears his roots.
He turned his back against
it.
And now God says to us today,
I am blessing you as God. But after this moment, shift. Move to a level. A level I have prophesied for you. A level I have prepared for you. And a level I have promised you. Be blessed and enjoy the rest of Father's Day.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Can we give Jesus a big hand of praise in the house this morning? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.